Hello everyone, welcome to video lecture series of Communication Engineering. Today's topic is Quadrature Amplitude Modulation, that is QAM. In this video, I will be talking about QAM modulator, QAM demodulator, advantages, disadvantages and applications. So let us begin. What do you understand by Quadrature Amplitude Modulation or QAM? So quadrature amplitude modulation, it is a modulation technique that we can utilize in analog modulation concept as well as in the digital modulation concept. So it could be utilized in both the cases, in analog modulation and digital modulation. So depending upon the input signal form, what is the nature of input signal, we can use it in either analog or digital modulation schemes. It could be utilized, right? So quadrature amplitude modulation, it can be defined as a modulation technique which can be used to combine two amplitude modulated waves into a single channel. This is a very important point. It can be combined into a single channel so that the channel bandwidth can be increased. This is why it can be utilized, you know, to a number of applications. So in case of QAM, we can modulate two individual signals and transmit them to the receiver. By using two input signals, the channel bandwidth will increase. And the QAM, this is capable to transmit two message signals over a same channel. So here channel is same where the two messages have been transmitted. This type of technique which we are talking about, QAM, it is also known as a quadrature carrier multiplexing. So this is also known as a quadrature carrier multiplexing, as now you can understand, because it is capable to transmit two messages on a same channel, right? And this is very much utilized because it provides the increased channel bandwidth. Now let us discuss about the QAM modulator. First you need to draw the block diagram. This is the block diagram of QAM modulator or transmitter. Here you can observe, in this particular diagram there are two inputs, as we have discussed that it is capable to combine two amplitude modulated waves into a single channel, right? So here number of inputs are two, input 1 and input 2. At the same time, two product modulators, product modulator 1 and product modulator 2, have been used in this particular case. There is a use of local oscillator also, and there is a 90 degree phase shift network. So if the local oscillator, it gives you A cos omega CT, then the 90 degree phase shifted network, at this particular output you will be getting A sin omega CT. So here you can observe that there are two sections actually. One is the upper section, one is the lower section. In the upper section you can observe there is a use of product modulator 1, local oscillator, and this particular section, this is known as in phase channel, right? This is known as in phase channel. While in the lower section you can see there is a product modulator 2 and the local oscillator, and this is 90 degree phase shifted. So this is known as a quadrature channel. So here you can observe the two channels. One is in phase channel and second is the quadrature channel. And the output of these two, means in phase and quadrature phase, these are summed up into this particular summer, and at the output we will be getting a QAM, quadrature amplitude modulated signal. So this is how at the output or the QAM modulator will generate the signal. Similarly, you can draw the related waveform as well. See, there are two waveforms for the carrier, carrier 1 and carrier 2. You can observe this is the carrier 1, this is the carrier 2, and there is a 90 degree phase shift in between both the carriers. So the QAM output resultant waveform, that will be of this particular nature. Here you can observe one is in phase channel output signal and the second is the quadrature channel, means the two output waveforms we are getting, and the resultant will be getting the QAM signal. Now let us talk about the QAM demodulator. How to draw the QAM demodulator so that we can get the original signal back. So this is the block diagram of a QAM demodulator. Here input is the multiplex signal, input is the QAM signal, and from this signal we have to extract the original signal, signal 1 and signal 2. So here also you can observe that there are two product modulators, two low pass filter and local oscillator, and again there is a 90 degree phase shift network. So at the receiver signal, the QAM signal which we have obtained, means which was generated, now that particular signal is available at the input. So that is forwarded at two points, point number one in the upper section, point number two at the lower section. So now this QAM signal is forwarded from the upper channel of the receiver and from the lower channel of the receiver. Upper channel of the receiver, it consists of product modulator and the local oscillator. Lower channel of the receiver, it also consists of product modulator 2 and the carrier, which is 90 degree phase shifted. Now these resultant signals of the product modulator, now they have been forwarded and passed through the low pass filter, low pass filter 1 and 2. What is the nature of the low pass filter? It passes the low frequency components and blocks or attenuate the high frequency component. So these low pass filters are fixed to the cutoff frequencies. And what is the cutoff frequency? For low pass filter 1, the cutoff frequency is related to the input signal 1, and for the other one related to the input signal 2. It means the filtered output, whatever we are getting at the output of low pass filter 1 and the low pass filter 2, that is the recovered original signal, and at the output you will be getting these two signals. So this is how you can explain and you can draw the block diagram of QAM modulator. So till this particular point you are able to explain how the QAM signal is being generated and how the original signal is being recovered from the QAM signal. Now let us talk about the advantages, disadvantages and applications of QAM. First, advantages. There are various advantages, and some of the important advantages I have listed out over here. It supports high data rate. So one of the best advantage of QAM is it supports a high data rate. It means the number of bits can be carried by the carrier signals, right? Second, noise immunity is very high, therefore noise interference is very less. So this is one of the important advantage because of which it is utilized in a number of applications. Third is low probability of error value. So this is also one of the advantage. And next, it expertly uses channel bandwidth. The channel bandwidth utilization is done in a very perfect manner, in a very precise manner. So this is also one of the advantage. Next, let's talk about the disadvantages. Here in the case of the receiver, where we have to reconstruct or recover the original signal, the receiver is more complex in comparison to the receiver of other modulation types. It required coherent demodulation with exact phase and frequencies. So this could be a limitation. As QAM uses amplitude component of the signal to represent binary data, you are aware with the amplitude is being used. So linearity needs to be maintained. It means linear amplifier is required, and linear amplifier, it consumes more power. So that is one of the disadvantage of QAM. Some of the applications of QAM, various fields are there in which QAM is commonly used. First is the radio communication. So the application of QAM are mostly observed in radio communications and in data delivery application systems. QAM technique, it has wide applications in radio communication fields, because as the increment of the data rate is there, definitely there is an increase in the data rate, and that there is a chance of noise increment. But what happens in the case of QAM technique, it is not affected by noise interference, hence means it is an easy mode of the signal transmission, right? So that is the advantage. It has been successfully applied in the digital cable television, in the case of internet services, in cellular technologies, wireless device technologies, quadrature amplitude modulation is preferred. So these are some of the applications of the QAM. Thank you so much for watching this video.